Paltrocast. Jillian, Natalie, the first question I have is, do you both like to be called by those first names? Meaning, are you more of a Jill and you're more of a Nat, or Jillian and Natalie, is it?
I've never thought once to call you Nat.
Really?
Is that a thing?
Many people call me Nat.
Do you like it?
I don't love it.
Yeah.
I like it. I like it. I don't love it. I like the familiarity. I like that someone feels comfortable calling me that. I don't like the sound of
it. What about Natty Ice? Has anyone ever called
you that?
People
have called me that too.
You hate that?
Yeah, they don't like it. I like how it feels that someone knows me well enough that they want to call
me. It's very sweet.
It's not a fun name. It's not beautiful.
I love this respect.
It doesn't make me go, Nat.
I'm definitely not a Jill. No one calls me Jill. My mom used to, in my elementary school, if someone said Jill, she would go Ian. Like after the so just been Jillian, although people who are close to me call me Jilly.
I call you Jilly sometimes.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, we're going to come back to all that, and we're going to come back to complimenting Plan B, which was a fantastic movie. But both of you come from very interesting but similar backgrounds, where you're both writers, producers, voiceover people who do comedic roles most of the time. But I couldn't figure it out. Had you two worked together on any projects before this film?
No, not really. Except we did like a charity benefit show, like a live show. Like, I think that was like 2009 or something.
That's crazy.
2010.
Yeah, it must have been before then.
No, it was
in 2009. I was in SNL. And you came,
yes.
But we knew each other.
Yes.
So it has to be like
2009-ish. And we've known each other since then, but we'd never worked together on anything. So we were excited to do it on this.
Yeah.
Okay. So how much preparation, Jill, Ian, is there for a role like this, in that you're somebody that you didn't really know that well, but you're acting like it's your best friend and, you know, you're gutted by the loss of them? I know it's acting, but a lot of times they do chemistry reads and chemistry dates and all that before finalizing a cast. But this was filmed during COVID, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was filmed during COVID. Everything was like over FaceTime or phone calls. I met the director for the first time when we were spitting into tubes, getting ready to work together. So, you know, it was height of COVID and pretty crazy. And the thing was, Natalie was shooting Plan B, which was, you know, her directorial debut for a movie. And at the time, I remember we even sent you the script. And then I was like, read this part. No, wait, read this part now. Because I was like, it'd be so cool for you to be the alien.
Yeah, yeah.
Because originally, I think you were reading for my part.
Right.
And then I was like, I really believe it.
Yeah, and I was like,
I was like, you should be the alien. Yeah, like, that'd be so cool. And I don't think I've seen you do something like that yet. And
it was lucky that we both wanted to switch.
I know, it was cool. It was really meant to be.
Yeah, but I had to read it like during breaks while filming Plan B, because I had not, and we shot it immediately after I wrapped Plan B. But his question is, was it hard to pretend to be my best friend?
Oh, not at all.
Not at all.
We have kind of an instant connection, I feel like. Like a deeper instant connection.
I feel like the second you're shooting with someone, you either know, you know right away if you're like, I'd love to have a glass of wine with that person and then never work with them again. Or this is going to be a friend in my life for a very long time. And I honestly had that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Natalie, where does that wonderful accent come from in that alien life form?
I have no idea. I have no idea. I knew that Jillian and I was like, Jillian, is this anything? I knew that it would be somebody whose mouth could make the English words, because she had all the muscle memory and had her memories, but didn't quite know where to put the emphasis on the syllables, right? and also was talking for the first time. So I knew that it was like something that this alien had to get used to, and that would probably start off weird and then get a little bit more, you know, more human as she got to practice it and experience it. And so that's what I was trying to, you know, maintain in my head. It was like, what if someone got to be like, it's like if a baby was born into an adult body for the first time and like knew how to talk and walk, but like didn't know what life was and like everything else, you know? And so I was kind of basing it off that, I guess. Yeah.
but it comes across organic and wonderful. And it's well, I think you can take
compliment. I'm so relieved when you're so good at that.
Thank you. It is actually really, for a while we would talk like that. Like it was hard to get out of talking like this. Like it was like, we got stuck doing that.
Well, that works. And the last thing I'm going to ask both of you before I let you go, as again, writer, producer, on-screen talent, voiceover people, what's next? Or is it all, I'm totally fine all the time forever?
I wish it was.
Well, yeah, what if we just did this? We just kept doing this.
Yeah, we just promoted this movie until the day we died.
So many sequels.
I'm doing the morning show right now, which is really exciting, and I'm really happy to be a part of that. And I'm working on some other projects that I can't quite tell you about yet. And so is she, that I'm really excited about.
I'm getting set. Like, I just directed a music video. I'm hoping to do more of that, which was really fun. And, you know, just branching out a little bit more. I really like writing.
Yeah.
I like directing.
Are you allowed to say which music video or whose music video?
Yes. It's already out. It's this artist, Ben Abraham, did a song called If I Didn't Love You, and you can look it up on YouTube. And Charlie Day and Mary Elizabeth Ellis are starring in it, and it's pretty weird.
She did such a good job. It's such a great video.
Thank you,
friend. Yes.
Well, I look forward to the next projects to come from both of you, but congratulations on this film.
Thank you.
The Plan B compliments continue.
Thank you.
Onwards and upwards to you both, Jill and Matt.
Thank you, Dare.
Do you go by Dare? Does
anybody call you Dare?
Yeah.
You do.
Bye, Dare.
Paltrocast.